Hello dear students, so today we are going to discuss the unit first of standard 12th, that is reproduction. The first chapter of this unit reproduction is reproduction in organism. So we are starting with this chapter, reproduction in organism. Now when we talk about reproduction is a fundamental feature of every living organism. Either they are unicellular or multicellular. Reproduction is a process which helps the organism to continue their survival on this earth. Every organism on this earth is not able to survive indefinitely on this earth. Every organism dies after attaining certain age, either due to predation or an accident or either due to any disease or failure of the organs. So, the time period from the organism birth till the death, we call that time period as the lifespan. If we define it properly, the duration between the birth till the death of the organism is called lifespan. Now, this lifespan may be either of few minutes, few hours, if the organism is microorganism, very, very minute in size, or it can be of several thousand years. So the time period from the birth till the death of the organism is called lifespan. So this table is showing you the lifespan of different organisms. For 12th standard we have to go through this table because multiple choice questions are there in the exam pattern. For that we have to remember this table. This table is showing you the lifespan of different living organisms. Here you can see the microorganism, they have the lifespan of few minutes or few hours. There are few plants which have the lifespan of few months. There are many plants as well as animals which have the lifespan in years. And there are certain animals as well as certain plants which have the lifespan in hundreds of years. Till now, do you know the longest lifespan till now recorded is of a perennial tree, sequoia. This tree can survive for thousands of years. Generally, we have studied that plants have greater lifespan than animals. Why is it so? Is it so because plants, they continuously grow, as they have the meristematic tissue at their tip regions or the regions where meristematic tissue is present, they continuously grow. And the major part, they grow, still they have the dead tissue in their body. Then also they keep on growing. That's why these plants, they have the longer lifespan than animals. Okay. Now when we talk about reproduction, if we want to define it, we will define it as that reproduction is a biological process by which any new individual organism or the offsprings are produced from their parents. Reproduction is also known as procreation or breeding. In this process of reproduction, every living organism makes a copy of itself. There are many methods of reproduction in the living organism and they are broadly categorized as asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. In asexual reproduction, the new individuals are produced by any means other than fusion of sex gametes. Yes, in asexual reproduction, only one parent is involved and there is no production of sex gametes, meiosis. Meiosis, the division by which chromosome number reduced to half, that does not occur in asexual reproduction. Whereas in sexual reproduction, it involves both the parents, and these both the parents, they are providing their gamete cells which are going to fuse to form a zygote, and the zygote will develop into a new organism. So here, gametes are formed because of meiosis and further fusion of gametes takes place. So, reproduction is broadly categorized into two categories, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Now, this table is giving you the differences between asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction, and it is an important question that how asexual and sexual reproduction are different. Asexual reproduction involves only single organism, whereas sexual reproduction involves two organisms. In asexual reproduction, there are no production of gametes, whereas in sexual reproduction, male and female gametes are produced. Because there are no production of gametes in asexual reproduction, fusion does not take place. In sexual reproduction, fusion of male and female gametes takes place. For the formation of gametes only, meiosis occurs. So in asexual reproduction, there is no meiosis, only mitotic division occurs. Whereas in sexual reproduction, both meiotic and mitotic divisions occur. In asexual reproduction, the offspring will be identical to their parents. As only single parent is involved in this reproduction method, so they will be the identical copies, and these identical copies are known as clones. They are genetically, morphologically identical to their parent. Whereas in sexual reproduction, some of the characters, they come from male parent and some of the characters from the female parent. So, there are variations in the offsprings in case of sexual reproduction. Because in asexual reproduction, one parent is involved, genetic variation only comes by mutation, not by reproduction. If there is any chance of genetic variation, it will be by mutation only. Whereas in sexual reproduction, genetic variation occurs at the time of sexual reproduction, and it may be due to other reasons. It may be due to genetic drift, it may be due to natural selection, it may be due to mutation, and so on. In asexual reproduction, there is no use of natural selection in evolution of species. Whereas, as I have told you, in sexual reproduction, natural selection is possible, and that makes the offsprings more adaptable, more evolved. More evolved species are developed by natural selection in case of sexually reproducing organism. If we talk about asexual reproduction, there are many modes of asexual reproduction, such as budding, fragmentation, sporulation, vegetative propagation, right? Whereas sexual reproduction occurs in plants, pollination occurs first, and finally fertilization occurs. Fertilization is a common method or common step in animals and plants both. So I hope the differences between asexual and sexual reproduction are clear. Now we are moving towards the different types of asexual reproduction. As you can see here, there are different types of asexual reproduction, like binary fission, where a single parent cell divides into the daughter cells, where a single parent cell divides into a daughter cells, like in bacteria, in amoeba, in paramecium. We will talk about it in detail. Another method is budding, where the parent cell produces the bud and this bud gets detached and develop into a new individual, like in yeast and hydra. Budding takes place. They are the methods of asexual reproduction. Another method is spore formation, where during unfavorable conditions, the spores are formed, and when the favorable conditions occur, the spores develop into a new individual. In fungi, ferns, bacteria, spore formation occur. Another asexual reproduction method is fragmentation, where the organism filamentous body, it should be like filament, it breaks into small fragments. And each fragment is capable to develop a new individual. It occurs in spirogyra, it also occurs in planaria. Another method is regeneration, where in regeneration, the body parts which breaks up, which are damaged, they can be repaired. Or organism body breaks up into several parts and each part develops into a new individual. That occurs in planaria, as you can see in the diagram, and also in hydra. And the last method of asexual reproduction is vegetative propagation, where the organism new individual body is produced by the vegetative part of the plant. This method of asexual reproduction is only followed by plants. Plants which have the vegetative parts which can form the new individuals. Like in potato, in onion, in ginger, we will see this type of asexual reproduction, that is vegetative reproduction. Now we are going to study about each mode of asexual reproduction in detail. First of all, we will start with binary fission. Now here you can see there are different types of binary fission, and this categorization of binary fission is done according to the direction, according to the axis at which binary fission occur. Like in this Euglena, you can see there is the longitudinal binary fission. The parent body splits longitudinally into two daughter cells. So this type of binary fission is called longitudinal binary fission. In this paramecium, you can see the parent body splits into two new individuals by transverse axis, on this transverse line. So this type of binary fission is called transverse binary fission, horizontally. This parent body is splitting horizontally into two individuals. Whereas in case of amoeba, there is not a fixed symmetrical line for the binary fission. Here the parent body can divide at any axis into two daughter individuals. So this type of binary fission is called irregular type of binary fission. So these are the different types of binary fission. Binary fission where the parent body gets splitted into two new individual organisms, and they are further categorized as longitudinal binary fission, where the parent body is dividing vertically. Transverse binary fission, where the parent body is dividing horizontally. And irregular binary fission, where there is no fixed axis for the division or for the splitting of the parent body. Next type of fission is multiple fission. Binary fission means where the parent body was dividing into two new individuals only. Here, the number of daughter cells or number of new individuals formed from parent are not two, they are more than two. In multiple fission, the parent body divides into many individuals. Here we can see the example in Plasmodium. In Plasmodium, which is a malarial parasite. In Plasmodium, the multiple fission takes place, and this multiple fission takes place in the parent cell. The parent cell nucleus and the cytoplasm, they are producing many small spore-like structures within the cell membrane. They are still in a cell. All the parts, all the new cells which are formed are still bounded within a membrane, and they remain so till the unfavorable conditions. And when the conditions become favorable, the membrane of the parent cell, it open up, and each daughter cell get released to form a new plasmodium. This is how multiple fission takes place in Plasmodium. Multiple fission is also seen in amoeba, where also the individual first gets surrounded by a resistant coat, cyst, the covering that is called as cyst. Then before they are released from the parent, the individuals which are surrounded within the cyst, they are released only during the favorable conditions. And each daughter cells, they develop into a new amoeba. So Plasmodium and amoeba, they both are showing multiple fission. Okay. Now the next method of asexual reproduction is budding. In budding, Formation of a daughter individual is always from a small projection. This small projection is called bud, which arise from the parent plant. Like here, in case of hydra, you can see the buds arise from the surface of the parent body. Each bud grows and gradually assume the form and size of the parent. When fully grown, the individual, it gets separated from the parent body and it becomes an independent animal. This is how budding takes place in hydra. Similarly, budding is also seen in yeast. Yeast, which is an unicellular fungi. During this process of budding in yeast, the parent cell develops a small protuberance which grows in size. The parent nucleus divides and one of the nucleus, it moves to the bud. Finally, the bud gets detached and grows into a new individual. This is how budding takes place in yeast. I hope budding is clear in both hydra and yeast. Now, we are moving to the next method of asexual reproduction, that is called spore formation. Here, spores are the propagules which germinate to produce the new individual. There are different types of spores here you can see. We are going to discuss about them. First of all, in this picture you can see the zoospores. The zoospores are a special kind of motile and flagellated spores which are produced inside the zoosporangium. Right? This is the structure called zoosporangium in which many motile spores, zoospores are produced. This type of spore formation is generally seen in the fungi, phycomycetes fungi, and also we see this in chlamydomonas algae. Now, the second type is sporangiospores. Sporangiospores are the non-motile spores which are produced inside the sporangium. These are the sporangium and these are the sporangiospores. They are non-motile. There are no flagella on them. So, these spores are also known as endospores sometimes. They usually dispersed by winds and they germinate to produce a new mycelium of the fungi. This type of spores, sporangiospores, are mostly found in fungi like rhizopus, mucus, etc. The next type of spores are conidiospores. Here you can see the conidiospores. These are again the non-motile spores which are produced single or in chain. You can see the chain of spores here. So these are the chain which are produced on the tip of the special hyphal branches. These are the hypha. Hypha are the strand of mycelium. Single strand of mycelium. Mycelium is the structure, net-like structure of fungi. And its single thread is called hypha. This hypha get branched to form the conidiophore. On these tips, the chain of conidias are formed. And later on, when these conidias are dispersed by wind, they germinate and form the germ tube and develop into a new hypha, mycelium of the fungi. This type of spores, they are called chlamydospores. They are formed within the chlamydomonas. Chlamydomonas, the algae, which show these type of spores, chlamydospores. These chlamydospores are thick-walled, resting spores which are produced directly from hypha. And they are capable of withstanding the unfavorable conditions. Here it is oidia. Again, they are same, non-motile, but they are not so thick-walled. These type of spores are present in albugo fungi. So most of them are present. Spore formation is mostly followed by all types of fungi for the asexual reproduction method. And some methods of spore formation is also followed by ferns as well as some algae. I hope the spore formation is clear to you now. Next, we are moving to the another mode of asexual reproduction, that is gemmule. Okay, before that, I want to give you an interesting fact that the Chlamydomonas, which is an algae, can reproduce both asexually and sexually. Both sexual and asexual reproduction are present in Chlamydomonas. Next mode of asexual reproduction is gemmule formation. This type of asexual mode of reproduction is generally seen in fresh water sponges. In fresh water sponges, this type of asexual mode of reproduction is present. Now, gemmules, they are the dormant, inactive structures produced asexually by the formation of specialized exogenous bud at certain time of the year. Here, there are certain cells which are surrounded by a thick protective covering. These cells, which are surrounded by this thick protective covering, it formed, or it is termed as gemmule. After gemmule formation, the original sponge body, it gets disintegrated. And these gemmules, they remain in dormant stage in the unfavorable conditions. And when favorable conditions come, the floating gemmules, they produce the new sponge. So this type of asexual reproduction called gemmule formation is generally seen in sponges, freshwater sponges. The next method of asexual reproduction is called fragmentation. This type of asexual reproduction is generally found in multicellular organisms with the simple body organization. These organisms are comprised of random collection of cells, but still they are not differentiated into specialized tissue and organs. So they are multicellular, but they are of simple level of organization. Such organisms reproduce by breaking of their body into small pieces, and these pieces are called fragments. These fragments grow into new individual. This mode of reproduction is called fragmentation. Like here you can see in planaria, the body gets split into fragments and each fragment can produce a new daughter planaria. This type of reproduction is also seen in some filamentous algae like Spirogyra. Here you can see the filament of Spirogyra gets split into fragments and each fragment can produce a new Spirogyra. Generally, the students get confused that what is the difference between fragmentation and regeneration. So here I am clearing that doubt that fragmentation of an organism is resulting when each fragment is growing into a new individual organism. That is called fragmentation. Yes, amoeba, hydra. Hydra also shows fragmentation. So fragmentation, if the question comes about fragmentation examples, planaria, Spirogyra, hydra, they all are showing fragmentation mode of asexual reproduction. While in case of regeneration, regeneration occurs when an organism want to regrow the lost part of the body. That is called as regeneration. I hope this is clear, that fragmentation, when the fragment is growing into a new individual, and regeneration, when the lost part is regrowing, is repaired by the development of the cells. Now, that's all for today. We'll discuss about vegetative reproduction further. Thank you.